It wasn't just something that I did for myself. In the past, when I couldn't stick properly, my mom would help me stick some of the stickers. And then my brother came along and started spoiling some of the albums because he couldn't stick the stickers properly. Hi, my name is Navin Nambia. I'm 38 years old. I own a social football league in Singapore called the X League, and I also lecture at Nanyang Polytechnic. I teach marketing, public relations, and sports communications. I think I was only like 5 years old. I didn't know anything about stickers. So it was my mom that actually introduced me to sticker collecting. She used to drive me around because for some reason we thought that collecting the stickers in a specific area would only lead you to certain numbers. That's where the whole interest in sticker collecting all began. Of course, in the early years, money was the biggest challenge. At first, we started collecting separate albums, and we found out it was a bit too expensive to complete two albums. So we started sharing. I mean, these things were not exactly cheap. Being able to buy a couple of packets a day, that's basically your entire recess money. Many of the albums in my collection are actually a collaboration between me and my brother, and we collect together and complete the albums together. So later on, the challenge was to actually find a similar group of collectors who had similar interests to come together and exchange these stickers. And kids, they will actually be at the shop. So when you actually go down to the shop to purchase a sticker, there will be kids there waiting to exchange stickers with you. Because if you were to just keep buying and buying instead of actually exchanging the stickers, it's very costly to complete an album. It can cost you anything more than up to $500-$600 to complete an album. Back in 1986, my favorite player was Diego Maradona. All the money I had, could just afford to buy one packet of sticker. So I remember going daily to this shop, hoping that I'll finally get my favorite player. So there was this one occasion, I bought one sticker packet. Sometimes you have extras, meaning a duplicate of the stickers. And I think there was only six stickers in the packet. Five duplicates, but the sixth sticker was Diego Maradona. And I remember punching the air with my sticker. I was like, yes! It was as though I scored a goal in the World Cup. And I got home, and that particular sticker, I paid particular attention to it to make sure that it was perfectly stuck. After I put it down, I was like, oh, my album is now complete, though it wasn't completed. But for me, it was like, that was the most godly sticker in the collection. I went to the shop, and there was a boy there. He looked so depressed. I was like, hey, you want to exchange stickers? He was like, I just need one to complete my album. And at that time, in my album, I had pasted it already. I had the sticker that he wanted. It's Italia 90, if I'm not mistaken. So what happened was, he said, I'll give you 30 stickers that you don't have for your one sticker. Immediately, I took it out. I would never do it now, but back then, 30 stickers was just too enticing. Took it out, gave it to him, he pasted it, went to buy another packet from the shop and got the same sticker and pasted it back. So basically, I got free 30 stickers that I didn't have. That's the most memorable story. Sticker collecting was difficult because it was difficult to find people with similar interests in order to exchange. There wasn't a proper social platform to be able to find people to come and exchange stickers. The second Facebook was from Ping. When the group first started, there was probably about less than 10 collectors, and now we have more than 700 plus members. We have collectors coming from all over the world. People flying in from Brunei or flying in from Southeast Asia for this sticker collection. And you have like more than 500 people showing up and exchanging stickers and trading cards. It's just an awesome experience, and I'm so happy to see the club grow from less than 10 people to more than 700 members. It wasn't just something that I did for myself. In the past, when I couldn't stick properly, my mom would help me stick some of the stickers. My dad would actually buy sticker packets for us. So you come home with like 10 packets and I'll be like the happiest kid in the world. And then my brother came along and started spoiling some of the albums because he couldn't stick the stickers properly. It was like a family bonding session. I think that's something that we have kind of lost. All this nice bonding session, instead of, when you go to a restaurant, you see the kid watching a phone, there's no personal interaction. And I feel board games and sticker collections and stuff like that, this brings the family together, you know. One thing very interesting in these swapping sessions is you would see an old grandma and you would see a very young child. And you see stuff like that. You will see parents and their children, grandparents and their grandkids. It's just really awesome. Yeah, it's something that has transcended time, if you ask me. I think sticking stickers, people take it for granted, it's just something you open and stick. It's not. If you want to stick a proper sticker, you'll have to first adjust it accordingly before sticking it. So this is something that I teach my son, so there's a bit of discipline involved as well. Of course, he doesn't get it right, but you know, he has to start somewhere. So his album will be separate from mine. He would have his own album. The professional one, we keep it to late nights to stick. My friends didn't understand it at the time, but considering what my collection looks like now, I think I have no regrets. My collection is priceless. Even if you offered me $100,000, I wouldn't sell it to you, simply because of the memories that come along with every album. The family bonding, the fun moments, the awkward stickers being stuck, the really shiny ones that you pay particular attention to, collecting your favorite players and having a chat about it. It transcends generations, and it's like a family heirloom that you pass down from generation to generation. And I can't wait to pass it down to my kids when they're old enough. It's not something they get it now, probably in about 10-15 years time. And it's something that they will pass to their kids and grandkids as well. And that's why I think that sticker collecting is priceless. Thank you.